Greetings of the day. I am Dr. Mobidev Subbarao, Associate Professor, Department of EEE, Vignan Foundation for Science, Technology and Research. I am doing the course Digital Electronic Circuits. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about logic gates. Logic gates are invented by George Boole. He is an English mathematician. Before going to discuss about in details of the logic gates, first let us know where we are using these logic gates. The logic gates are using in the microcontrollers and processors in CPUs and processors in mobile phones. And these logic gates are used to make a combination circuits like multiplexers, demultiplexers, encoders, decoders, etc. and arithmetic circuits such as adders, subtractors, comparators. By combining above two, we will make a arithmetic and logic unit. And these logic gates are used to make flip-flops, counters, registers to store the data. By interfacing the arithmetic and logical unit and stored data, we get a processing unit. These processing units are using in the applications which you have seen, like cell phones, laptops and different digital devices. Object of today's lecture is identify basic gates and describe the behavior of each. Second objective is describe the behavior of gate or circuit using Boolean expressions, truth tables and logic diagrams. And third objective of this is combine basic gates into circuits. Upon completion of today's lecture, you will be able to learn difference between all types of the logic gates and knowing the behavior of the gate using Boolean expressions, truth tables and logic diagrams, and able to solve the problems related to combining of the basic circuits gates. Introduction of the logic gates. Logic gates are the basic building blocks for forming digital electronic circuit. These logic gates are physical devices implementing a Boolean function, that is, it performs a logical operation on one or more logic inputs and produce a single logic output. So, inputs and outputs of these logic gates are either high or low. These existing logic gates are classified into two types. One type is basic gates, another variety is derived gates from the basic gates. By combining these two, the logic gates are having of seven types. First one is AND gate, second one is OR gate, third one is NOT gate. These three gates are called as a basic gates. And next gate is NAND gate, NOR gate, XOR gate, XNOR gate. These four gates are derived gates from the basic gates. So, total logic gates are of 7. So, if you see the circuit symbol of each and every gate and its Boolean expression. This is the circuit symbol of NOT gate and its Boolean expression is XOR. And similarly, circuit symbol of AND gate, it is two input gate and inputs are X and Y. Output is X and Y. In general mathematics, we can call it is X into Y. This is circuit symbol of OR gate and its Boolean expression is XORY. In general mathematics, we call it is X plus Y. And this is three input AND gate, but output is one only. And this is three input OR gate and output is single output. From these three basic gates, the other gates are derived. The first one is NAND gate. This is combination of NOT and AND gate. NOT and AND are the basic gates. By combining those two gates, one gate is derived, that gate is NAND gate. So, if you observe the expression, the inputs are X and Y, output is XY bar, that is X into Y is the AND operation. Its complement operation is NAND. Similarly, NOR gate, this is also a derived gate from the basic gate. So, which is derived by combining OR and NOT gate. So, if you observe the expression, X and Y are the inputs and X plus Y bar is the output. And next gate is XOR gate. This is exclusive OR operation that we will see in the coming class. So that is about the different gates and their Boolean expressions and circuit symbols. Now we will discuss the two tables of logic gates. First one, AND gate. This is the circuit symbol of AND gate, and it having of two inputs, one output. Two inputs are A and B. Output is Q. The Boolean expression for AND gate is A into B, that we already seen in the previous slide. Now the truth table for the AND gate is A, B are the inputs, Q is the output. The truth table consists of different combinations of inputs and the respective output. When the input is A is low and B is low, the output is low because the AND gate output is A into B. A is low, B is low, that's why 0 into 0 is equal to 0. Next, the input A is low, that is 0 state, and B is high, then the output is low because A into B is the output of the AND gate. Here, one of the input to the AND gate is low, that's why output is low. The third combination is A input is high, B input is low, thereby the output is low. The fourth combination is both inputs are high, then the output is high. This what about the truth table for AND gate. After observing the truth table, the conclusion is AND gate output is low when any one of the input is low. AND gate output is high only when both inputs are high. The next one is OR gate. A is the input for the OR gate and B is the other input for the OR gate, and the output is Q. The Boolean expression for OR gate is A plus B. The respective truth table for the OR gate is when input A is low and B is low, then the output is low because A plus B combination is the output. So A is low, B is low, thereby output is also low. Next combination, input A is low but B is high. By the Boolean expression of OR gate, A plus B, the output is high. Similarly, the next combination is A is high, B is low, thereby output is high. The final combination is both inputs are of high, then the output is high. Thereby the conclusion from the truth table for OR gate is when any one of the input is high, the output is high. If both inputs are of low, output is low. The next gate is NOT gate. This NOT gate is also called as a inverter gate or complementary gate. So it is single input gate. The single input is A and its complement is the output, that is Q. Here we consider the corresponding truth table is, because of single input we have only two combinations. One combination is high, the other combination is low. So its complement is the output. So if input is low, its complement is high. That's why output is high. Similarly, the second combination, when the input is high, the output is low. So that what is called as a NOT operation of the gate. So next logic gate is combining logic gates. This is also called as a derived logic gates, because already the logic gates are classified into two types, that is seen in the previous slides. One classification is basic logic gates, another classification is derived logic gates. One of the derived logic gate is NAND gate. That only the circuit seen here. The combination of AND and NOT gate is nothing but the NAND gate. So if you see here, first gate is AND gate. The second gate is NOT gate. By combining these two, you will get the NAND gate. So A and B are the inputs for the AND gate. The C is output from that AND gate, which is A into B. Then its complement is the output from the NOT gate. That's why here Q is the output. There Q is nothing but A into B whole bar. That is also called as A B complement. So this is the circuit symbol of NAND gate, and inputs are A and B, output is C from the AND gate, and its complement is the Q. So where Q is A into B complement. So that's why this is also called as a AND with bubble. AND with bubble is called as NAND gate. That bubble represents NOT operation. AND gate with NOT gate is called as a NAND gate. And the truth table for the NAND gate is here. Here the inputs are two only, A and B, where C is the output of AND gate, Q is the output of NOT gate. So because of two inputs, the possible combinations are four. Those are 00, 01, 10, 11. So let us see one by one. When both inputs are of low, that is nothing but 00, the AND gate output is 0, that already seen at the AND gate truth table. And its complement is the NAND gate output. That's why Q is 1. So like that, the combinations of AND gate are seen here. Those are 01, 10, 11. The respective AND gate outputs are 0, 0, 1. So its complemented outputs are outputs of the NAND gate. So that's why when C is the 0, its complement is 1. Similarly, next combination is also 1. The next combination is also 1. The next combination is 0, because the C input is high state, that's why its complemented output is low. That's why if you observe the NAND gate operation, when any one of the input is low, output is high. That is complement to the AND operation. In the AND gate, what we observed is, if any one of the input is low, output is low. But in the NAND gate, if any one of the input is low, output is high. And if all inputs are of high, output is low. So the next derived gate is NOR gate. The circuit diagram of NOR gate is combination of OR and NOT. Combination of OR and NOT is the NOR gate circuit. So A and B are the inputs for the OR gate. Its output is C. Here the C output is output from the OR gate, whose Boolean expression is A plus B. And its complement is the output from NOR gate, which is A plus B complement, or A plus B bar. So this what is the NOR gate circuit symbol with two inputs. And coming to the truth table for NOR gate, here also two inputs A and B. Output from the OR gate is C, and output from the NOT gate is Q. Whole by A and B are the inputs for the NOR gate, and Q is the output from the NOR gate. So here also we have four combinations of input because of two inputs. Those four combinations are 0, 0, 0 is the output from the OR gate, and 0, 1 whose output is 1, which is from the output of OR gate. 1, 0 is the input from the OR gate, and whose output is 1. So 1, 1 is the input and output is 1. So, and the final output of NOR gate is when inputs are 00, output is 1. When input of 01, output is 0. When input of 10, output is 0. When the input of 11, output is 0. Thereby, if you observe the truth table of NOR gate, when any one of the input is high, output is low, which is complement to the OR gate. Next gate, exclusive OR gate. This is the circuit symbol of exclusive OR gate, and it is also a two input gate. A and B are the inputs, and output is A exclusive B, and its Boolean expression is A exclusive B is equal to A bar B plus A B bar, and its truth table A and B are the inputs and Q is the output. First combination, A is 0 and B is 0, and output is 0. How it is mean? When A is 0, its complement is 1, and A bar B operation is 1 into 0. That's why it is 0. Second part of the Boolean expression of XOR gate is A B bar. A is 0, B is 0, and its complement is 1. That's why A B bar value is 0 into 1. So, it is 0. By OR operation, 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. So, when A is 0, B is 0, its exclusive OR output is 0. Second combination, when A is 0, B is 1, and its output is 1. Similarly, when A is 1, B is 0, and its output is 1. And last combination, A is 1, B is 1, its output is 0. So, from the truth table, when both inputs are of same, its output is 0. If inputs are of different, output is 1. That what is the conclusion of exclusive OR gate operation from the truth table. And next gate, exclusive NOR gate. It is complement of exclusive OR gate. So, if you see the circuit symbol, at the output side, we have a bubble. So, that bubble represents NOT operation. You see, the output consists of a bubble. That bubble represents NOT operation of exclusive OR gate. So, expression of output, if you see there, Y is equal to A exclusive B whole complement. Thereby, its Boolean expression is A B plus A bar B bar. That is the Boolean expression for the exclusive NOR gate. And coming to the truth table, here also we have two inputs, A and B, and output is Q. So, here also we have four combinations from the two inputs. So, first combination is 0, 0. Its output is 1. Second combination is 0, 1. Its output is 0. Third combination is 1, 0. Its output is 0. Fourth combination is 1, 1. Its output is 1. this is exactly complement to the XOR gate. From the truth table, the conclusion is, if both inputs are of same, its output is high, which is complement to the exclusive OR gate. Similarly, if any one of the input is high or low, nothing but if inputs are of different, output is low. That what is the conclusion from exclusive NOR gate. So far we have observed 7 varieties of gates which are using in the digital electronics. Once again, I am repeating the existed gates in digital electronics. Those are 7 in number. Basically, those 7 are categorized into 2 types. One categorization is basic gates. Another classification is derived gates. So, under basic gates and or not are the gates. Under derived gates, NAND, NOR, exclusive OR and exclusive NOR. So, total 7 gates with 2 classification. In this one, there are 2 gates. One is NAND gate and the one is NOR gate. We called those 2 gates as a universal gates, because by using those 2 gates, we can realize any gate. That is, we can realize NAND gate with NAND gate, we can realize OR gate with NAND gate, we can realize AND gate with NAND gate, we can realize NOT gate with NAND gate, we can realize exclusive OR gate with NAND gate, we can realize exclusive NOR gate with NAND gate. Similarly, we can realize all the 6 gates with NOR gate. That's why those 2 gates are called as a universal gates. We will see about that universal gates in the next lecture. Now, we will solve some problems related to gates. Yes. Question 1. Find the output of the following circuit. Find the output of the following circuit. You see, the circuit is given here. X, Y are the inputs. X, Y are the inputs. And this gate is OR gate. This gate is NOT gate. This gate is AND gate. So, we need to find what is the output from this combined structure of the gate. So, here the output from OR gate is X plus Y. The output from NOT gate is Y bar. So, for this AND gate, inputs are X plus Y and Y bar. So, its output is X plus Y into Y bar. That what is the output from the gates combination given in this problem. Similarly, we will see next question. Find the output of the following circuit. This what is the given circuit. If you see, X and Y are the inputs and these 2 gates are NOT gates, and this gate is AND gate, this gate is again NOT gate. So, that's why if X is the input to first NOT gates, its output is X bar. Similarly, if Y is the input to this NOT gate, its output is Y bar. So, these 2 are the inputs to this AND gate. So, its output is X bar into Y bar. So, this X bar into Y bar is the input to the NOT gate. Thereby, its output is X bar, Y bar, whole combination is complemented. That's why X bar, Y bar, whole bar. That what is the output from the combined circuit. So, next question. Write the circuit for the following Boolean algebraic expression. So, in the previous two questions, we have a circuit. From that circuit, we derived the expression. Okay, in this question, we have a Boolean expression. For that Boolean expression, we need to realize a circuit. So, this what is the expression? X bar plus y. X bar plus y is the expression. So, here x and y are the two inputs. So, first input is x and its complement. That's why what we require is x its complement. Then we get the x bar. So, we need not gate. And x bar plus y, nothing but R operation is happening here. So, x bar and y are the inputs to the R gate and its output is x bar plus y. So, that what is the circuit or logic circuit for the given Boolean expression. So, similarly, next question, write the circuit for the following Boolean algebraic expression. So, here the expression, x plus y whole bar into x. So, it is also a two input, but it having a different combination of the logic gates. So, if you observe the first expression, x plus y whole bar. So, x plus y required for doing of this algebraical expression x plus y, we required AND gate. So, for doing of x plus y operation, we required R gate. So, if you see the circuit, x and y are the inputs. The first operation is R operation because the first concept of x plus y. So, that's why R gate is required. And for that R output, we need to do complement. So, we require NOT gate. So, this what is the circuit combination for first expression, x plus y whole bar. And this x plus y whole bar is operating AND operation with x. So, if you see the circuit, for the AND gate, inputs are x plus y whole bar and x. So, in order to realize this Boolean expression, three basic gates are required. One is R, second one is NOT, third one is AND. So, this what is the circuit diagram for the given Boolean expression. So in this lecture, we learn what are the different varieties of logic gates and their circuit symbols and their Boolean expressions and how to realize the gates combination for a given Boolean expression and how to find the Boolean expression for a given combination of gates circuit. Thank you.